Alo.
Alo. Hello, profesör.
Hello. Hello. Yes,
Can
Dr.
you hear
Correa.
me?
Yeah.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Same
Okay,
here.
I'm sharing my screen.
Okay, sure. So shall I introduce first?
Okay.
Then we can start.
Yes.
So hello viewers. Welcome to our second session of fourth day International 1 week online lecture series on trends in artificial intelligence and machine learning. So today's this session speaker is Dr. Korhan Sengiz, and he is from Turkey. And Sengiz has received his BS degree in Electronics and Communication Engineering from Kocaeli University, Kocaeli, Turkey, and MS degree in Electronics and Communication Engineering from Namık Kemal University, Tekirdağ, Turkey, and the PhD degree in Electronics Engineering from Kadir Has University, Istanbul, Turkey, in 2016. And currently he is working as an assistant professor in the Department of Electrical Electronics Engineering, Trakya University, Edirne, Turkey. His research interests include wireless sensor networks, routing protocols, wireless communication, statistical signal processing, indoor positioning systems, power electronics, and 5G. He is an editor of the Turkish Journal of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. So, I welcome all of you to participate or to listen his talk. So, Dr. Korhan, now over to you. You can carry on.
Okay, can you hear me and the presentation visible?
We can hear you clearly, but your presentation is, I think it is not yet, it is not visible.
We can see your presentation.
Yes, I'm sharing right now my screen. Can you see? Can you see the presentation?
Yes, I can see.
No.
Yes, is it visible now? Okay, good. So I'm beginning. Okay.
Yes, you can start now.
Okay. Okay. Hello everyone. Thank you for joining our session. As professor introduced me, I'm Korhan Cengiz, assistant professor from Trakya University, Edirne. And especially I'm working in telecommunications field and network layer in the OSIC layer. So today I will talk about energy efficient protocols for wireless sensor networks. And this is our outline. Here we have, first we will start with motivation, and then I will show you some related works. And after the related works, I will try to explain you especially low energy fixed clustering algorithm, which is designed by me and my colleagues, and also its extension of multi-hop low energy fixed clustering algorithm. And also I will try to show their simulations and results. And finally, I will talk about some conclusions and the future studies for the researchers. So as a motivation, we know that wireless sensor networks are widely used in the literature, especially for recent 20 years. So it has thousands of usage area, for example, disaster relief, target tracking, environmental control, smart cities, medicine, and especially healthcare. And the healthcare part is so critical, you know, especially we use sensor networks in body area networks, wireless body area networks. So therefore, it is very critical for live application. So the collecting information and obtaining the scalable information and also obtaining the information without any connection loss from the network is very critical, especially for healthcare. So in sensor networks, we have three main approaches to contain the to collect the information from the network. The first one is direct transmission, the second one is multi-hop routing, and finally we use clustering. So in direct transmission, our sensor nodes measures the data from the environment. For example, think about that, you are measuring temperature from the environment. So these sensor nodes try to send the collected information to the base station directly. In multi-hop routing, they used each other as a relay nodes to sending the information. And finally, in clustering, there are some partitions, and in these partitions, they are called as clusters, and there are cluster heads responsible for collecting the information from the members, and then these cluster heads transmit this information to the base station, remote base station. So we are also focusing on here clustering protocols, and also our LEFCA, designed LEFCA, is also a clustering protocol. So, but we know that cluster topologies in the literature change very frequently in routing protocols. So there are some problems. The first one is increase in energy consumption. The second one is decrease in network lifetime. And the final one is additional network over. So our protocol, LEFCA, tries to solve these problems by using fixed clustering and also changing the cluster head determination process of the existing algorithms. And here, as a related work, we should first look at Leech protocol. Leech protocol is the most known and most famous routing protocol for wireless sensor networks. It has 20 years history, and it has two main steps in processing: setup phase and the steady state phase. In the setup phase, the cluster formation things occur, and in the steady state phase, data transmission from the collected information to the base station is done. So these processes, these steps are done for each round in Leech protocol. So this causes to additional network overhead in the network. And by using fixed clustering, we aim to decrease this, especially this huge network traffic in the environment. So we try to do only once, especially for this step, and then the clusters are fixed. So therefore, there is no need to make again cluster head advertisement, cluster formations, and also cluster election processes for each round. We made cluster head election processes for some rounds, and I will also explain it in the following slides. In related works, there are thousands of protocols which are extension to Leech, and they mainly focus on three things in the literature: changing the cluster head selection, determining the cluster heads according to the remaining energy, and also using fixed clustering. So here, especially, we focused on this part, and we aim to use fixed clustering algorithm in LEFCA. Also, Leech F is highly related with our proposed studies, because it has also fixed clustering nature. So it uses also fixed clusters, but our LEFCA has some improvements when we compared it with Leech F protocol. So also I will examine and present those details in the following slides. So also we have Modlitch. Modlitch is also a famous protocol in the literature, and it has threshold based mechanism in its nature, and also our protocol has threshold based mechanism. So we take some advantages of Modlitch and Leechf together in our proposed protocol. And also DEEC is another famous protocol, but it has heterogeneous network structure. Some nodes have more initial energies at the beginning of the network formation. So with our protocol is not highly related with a DEC network. So in addition, stable election protocol is a very famous and fundamental heterogeneous protocol. It has also some advanced modes which have more initial energies again. And also it has another different cluster head and weighted election probability based approach in its original nature. But we also took some advances of SEP protocol in LEFCA protocol. Also LEMA is another extension, but not widely used. And also ILH, PLH, there are thousands of extensions to Leech in the literature, you can see. So let's look at LEFCA. Our protocol aims to use fixed clustering and also determining the cluster heads by using the base station, by the control of base station. And LEFCA tries to combine these ideas together. In addition, it has smart cluster head determination mechanism, and this mechanism tries to determine the nodes that are almost at the center of the associated clusters at the beginning of the algorithm, instead of determining them randomly. In literature, generally, the algorithms determine the cluster heads randomly at the beginning and also goes on with random selections. But LEFCA, in initial stage at the beginning, tries to find most optimum cluster heads at the beginning, and it had some advantages in the initial stages. And also I will show this advantage in our simulation results. And also it has a threshold based cluster head selection mechanism, and some protocols have this idea in the literature already. But this is the important part of our protocol. It aims to abuse the energies of the cluster heads before determining a new cluster head, and this idea is not proposed in any of the existing algorithms in the literature. So this part is the novel part of our protocol. And also this is critical and dangerous idea, because we are trying to abuse the energies of the cluster heads. And when a cluster head becomes out of energy, then you cannot obtain and collect any information from that part of the network. So this is very critical. So you have to decide and define, and you have to make calculations very carefully while determining the threshold value in the network. Therefore, we made some derivations and calculations about it. Also, I will examine it now. And LEFCA has again set up and steady state phases, and it has set up and steady state phases in its also nature. So here this is the setup phase of LEFCA. This is the cluster head selection details of LEFCA. Can you hear me? Is there any problem? Is it visible?
Oh, and no, there is no problem. You carry on.
Okay. We have in cluster formation part, we have two main messages. The first message is about announcement message, the upper one. And in the announcement, a cluster head becomes the cluster head from the members. It is determined as cluster head and says that I'm cluster head by using this advertisement message in wireless channel. And then the normal members tries to join the cluster heads and they use cluster head joining message. So these messages for the existing algorithms, for each round, these messages are broadcasted in the network. But for Lefka network, we broadcast these messages only once at the beginning of the algorithm and also just when we need to change the cluster head, we use again these messages. So for example, for 400 rounds, we don't use these messages. And let's explain what is one round for us. For example, imagine that you put the sensor nodes in the field and sensor nodes starts to collect information from the environment and then this collected information transmitted to the cluster heads and then cluster head collects this information from the members and combines it into a single message and then transmit this single message, these single messages to the remote base station. So this is one round for us. So in Lefka network, at the beginning of the cluster head advertisement and cluster head selections, we had we have a lot of advantages while broadcasting these messages, and this provided us additional energy savings. We will see in results, and also it provided us very low network traffic in the wireless network. So also in clusters, for example, think that you have one cluster head and in that cluster you have 10 members. These are normal members and just measuring the environment and sending this information to the cluster head. So for each member there are time slots, and in this time duration this member is responsible to send the measured information to the cluster head, associated cluster head. So in here we used time division multiple access approach, and this the length of this frame is according to the number of nodes, number of members in a cluster. So this is also steady state phase of Lefka. In steady state phase, we are trying to transmit the information to the base station. And here, these are the time slots for members. They send the information to the cluster heads. And then cluster heads transmit the collected and combined information, single message to the base station. And here, if needed, we make cluster head decision phase because you remember that we abuse the cluster head as much as possible. So this part sometimes occurs in our Lefka network. So this is the details of data transmission. And now this part is very important part of our algorithm. We know that now Lefka has fixed clusters. Cluster heads may change at the beginning of a new Lefka round because we use the cluster heads and we are trying to abuse them. So when data transmission is completed, we should check for each cluster that the cluster head's energy is below the threshold value or equal to threshold value or higher the threshold value for each cluster, for each LI cluster, we should look at this. So, and this decision is made directly according to the cluster head's remaining energy. And if our cluster head's remaining energy is higher than a threshold value, behaves as a cluster head for the next coming rounds. But if the cluster head's remaining energy is below the threshold value, the existing cluster head should select a new cluster head from its members. So here in original LEFCA, we made this selection randomly, but also we made selecting the member with highest remaining energy approach. Also, we tried selecting the member which is closest to the existing cluster head approach, nearest fixed clustering algorithm. Also, these approaches were generated as some additional publications, proceedings in some IEEE conferences. So, also we obtained some publications and new solutions from this part, and also selecting the new cluster head with the highest energy provided us some additional energy savings. And here, LEFCA has the cluster head change decision, and we know that if we should determine the threshold value very carefully, I told before, but now I will also explain in details. And we should think the worst case schemes and worst case situations, because if we have any network disconnection, then it will cause to very critical problems. For example, thinking that this is a body area network, and for example, you are taking measurements from heart and critical body parts. So if you cannot get information from any part of the body for a while, it will cause to critical and life problems. So therefore, we should collect always information from our network. So here, to determine the threshold value, first we should use this equation. This equation shows us energy of a cluster head and energy dissipation of a cluster head while transmitting the information to the base station. And here, there is an important detail. There is a crossover distance in wireless propagation channel and wireless communication. For example, for our network, we have 100 sensor nodes, and our area has the dimensions of 100 meter times 100 meter. It's a square area. So, and our base station, for example, is placed to 150.50 coordinates. So we are trying to transmit information from this area to the to this remote base station. Here, for this parameters, the crossover distance is 87 meters. What is that? If any sensor nodes distance to the base station becomes higher than this value, it will lose its energy by the fourth power of the distance. But if the distance is less than this value, it will lose its energy by the second power of the distance. So we should decrease the transmission distances of the nodes and also cluster heads Therefore, we are using clustering algorithms here. So we are especially trying to decrease this distance to provide additional energy savings and also increase the lifetime of our sensor nodes, because our sensor nodes are small devices and they have only 2 joules initial energy at the beginning. For example, we have starting with 200 joule total initial energy in the network. Therefore, we should focus on and decrease this distance, and the clustering protocols, the wireless sensor network protocols, always focus on this part, trying to decrease this distance especially. And here, this is our case. This is our network, and this is our base station, remote base station. So here, these are some equations. So how can we decide this threshold value? How did we find it? Now, for our parameters, this is our this is the coordinates of our base station, and we imagine that here, I will show it now. We imagine that our cluster head is here, the remotest node to the base station, and there is only one cluster in the area, and all rest of the nodes are normal members and are joined to this cluster head. This is our worst case. So we have one cluster head and we have one cluster, and 99 nodes are just members. So for one round, this cluster head, try to solve this cluster head, how much energy will dissipate this cluster head for a one round for transmitting this information to the base station. So in this calculations, we found this value according approximately 0.005 joules. So then we thought that we can use this cluster head until this value, but we decided make guarantee the connections. We decided this value as 0.05 joule in Lefka. So in Lefka network, when a node is elected as a cluster head, it is abused until its energy becomes 0.05 joule. So it has 2 joules at the beginning, and we abuse that cluster head until its energy becomes 0.05 joule. So this is very novel idea, and it's also very critical, I said before. And for our some keynote speaks and some other presentations, we have argued with some researchers, and they say that there is an energy hole. It can cause to some problems. The first node that occurs very soon at the beginning of the algorithm. But for wireless sensor networks, there are 2 main lifetime metrics. The first one is first node death, and the second one is dying to all nodes in the network. So we decided to use the second idea in our proposed Lefka, and we said that our lifetime metric is looking the nodes that all nodes have 0 joule energy, then our network will finish. So therefore, by using this idea, did not cause to any problems in our lifetime matrix. And also here we have multi op Lefka. Let's show it. These parts are same, so I will show you from the figure here. Now, this is our Lefka network, but in this network, we use multi op Lefka. We designed multi op Lefka, and we were published in it's in IEEE Access Journal. So here we have, for example, four clusters, and for cluster one, our cluster head is 5. For cluster two, our cluster head is 11. And for example, for cluster four, it's 20. Now, for original Lefka, these nodes make measurements from the environment and then transmit these measurements to the cluster heads, and then cluster head transmits the collected information to the remote base station directly. But in multi-op Lefka, cluster heads use each other as relay nodes. So for here, cluster head 5 collected transmits the collected information to the node 11, the second cluster head, and then 11 also transmit the information of cluster 1 and also cluster 2 to the cluster head node 20, and finally cluster head node 20 transmits all information from the network to the base station. Here we can face a problem. For node 20, there can be a huge network load. So how can we solve it? For example, we can use here some super nodes which have additional energies. For example, these nodes have 2 joules energy at the beginning. Maybe for this part, for these clusters, they can have 5 joules at the beginning, 4 joules at the beginning. So this problem also can be solved by using a heterogeneous network. So also this can be applied to Lefka or multi-op Lefka as a new study for researchers. If anybody wants to make collaboration with me, we can discuss about it. And these are also same as Lefka network. Now let's see the simulation results. We conducted our simulations in MATLAB, and here, for example, as you remember, we said before, at the beginning Lefka makes intelligent cluster head determination, and Lefka tries to determine the cluster heads approximately in the center of the clusters at the beginning. And when we do like that, our algorithm, this part, this is the intelligent cluster head determination of Lefka, and this is the random selection at the beginning. So as you see, it provides approximately 10% lifetime improvement. So just beginning with smart selection, you obtain very significant energy savings. So we decided to use intelligent cluster head determination at the beginning of our Lefka protocol. And this shows the impact of threshold value. As you know that now, our threshold value is very low because we are trying to abuse, we are trying to use as much as possible our cluster heads, their energies. So, but we can also increase this value, and for specific applications, threshold value of Lefka can be changed there is no problem, and you can get and you can obtain optimal solutions for specific applications. There is no problem here. So here, for example, we showed some results for different threshold values in terms of different threshold values, and also for Lefka network, we aim to obtain the energy map of the network. For example, let's see the energy map. This is a snapshot from our Lefka network. For example, for this round, we wanted to see the status of the sensor nodes, their energies, and as you see, different colors correspond to different energy levels, and this one also another snapshot from the Lefka network. And as you see, when we go to the end of the network, the black nodes are significantly increased, and these black nodes are dead nodes. In our network terminology, we say them dead nodes, so they don't have, they have no energy, and they cannot measure, and they cannot transmit anything. They are dead nodes. And these are some explanations about energy map. Here, this is our remaining energy. Sorry. For our remaining energy here, Lefka provides very robust performance when we look at the figure. And for example, we made comparisons. Leech, this is a most famous protocol in the literature. When you look at wireless sensor networks, you will see at the beginning. So Leech F, as you remember, it is also fixed clustering. Mode Leech has some threshold-based mechanism. DEEC is heterogeneous protocol. Stable election protocol is also very famous in the literature. So Lefka has good performance when we compared it with other protocols in terms of residual energy. And here some additional comments. And this figure shows the number of aligned nodes. As you see that, we started with 100 nodes in the network, and we are trying to find how many nodes will stay for each round. So here, Lefka has approximately 5,500 lifetime. This means that we transmit information from network to the base station for 5,500 times. We collect measurements, for example, for 5,500 times. For example, you think that you are making fire measurements, and you make measurements 5 times in a day, so you can find how much time will Lefka provide you collecting information from this environment. And also for some protocols, time-based simulations, time-based analyses are done, but we use round-based simulations and round-based evaluations. And this is also the results of the network lifetime, the average lifetime and maximum lifetime. We obtain this average lifetime values according to 100 independent iterations. We generated the network randomly at the beginning, and these protocols are conducted for that situation, and then again we generated the network, and then again these protocols are conducted, and these values are the averages averaged for 100 iterations, and this result shows the total data transmitted to the base station. For some studies, you can see this as a throughput, but I didn't say throughput because throughput is a measure of the useful information transmitted to the receiver, I think. So this shows the total transmitted number of packets transmitted to the base station. For example, here, as you see that, for example, approximately for 5,000 rounds, we approximately 50,000 packets are transmitted to the base station. And for different node densities and results, also we evaluated LEFCA. For example, when we have 50 nodes for 100 area, what will happen? And also when we increase the number of nodes, then again what will happen? You see that LEFCA always has better performance when we compared with existing approaches. And also this result is for the base station. We put the base station inside of the measurement area and not remote base station. It is center of the our measurement area. And what will happen? Also, we examined that LEFCA has, again, better performance. And these are about comparisons with LEFCA and its extension, Multi-op LEFCA. Multi-op LEFCA provided us some additional energy savings and lifetime and maybe number of data transmission enhancements. But I also still studying on Multi-op LEFCA and trying to increase its performance. So here, for example, we have results for LEFCA and Multi-op LEFCA and number of packets again transmitted to the base station. So as a conclusion, we have here a fixed clustering approach, which is LEFCA, and it uses threshold-based clustered selection mechanism, but as a novelty, it aims to abuse the cluster heads as much as possible, abuse their energies as much as possible to provide additional lifetime improvements and also provide full connectivity in the network. So LEFCA is a suitable candidate, especially for fixed nodes, for example, fixed networks, for example, bed area networks, for example, fire measurements, earthquake measurements. But for mobile environments, we cannot use LEFCA because it's a fixed clustering approach. For example, for cell phone based or for 5G, 4G networks, we cannot use LEFCA. But for these types of applications, we can generate new solutions related with LEFCA, and therefore I'm also open collaborations with our researchers about this. And also for future study, the performance of LEFCA can be evaluated for large-scale networks. We didn't do it. And also, I think at the beginning of the LEFCA network, while the cluster formations processes, some machine learning or deep learning solutions can be applied to Lefka network. So I think there are some open problems still here. So for postdoc researchers or for PhD students or another researchers, I'm again saying that open for collaborations, we can study together to solve some problems of Lefka networks, wireless sensor networks, and also to improve its performance. So now it is finished. Is there any
hello
questions? Hello.
Okay. Yes, we have some questions. First question, okay. Let me in Lefka approach, sensor nodes are battery powered or it uses solar energy?
We started with initial power, but also this is a good question, I think. We can use solar energy and we can also increase their initial energies, and also we can provide some additional energy sources to them. It can be done, but it will provide some additional, you know, costs, especially money costs for the application, but it can be possible. We can use solar energy to provide additional initial energy storage to the sensor nodes.
Okay, so is there any chance in Lefka to activate dead nodes whose energy level goes below a threshold level?
Is there any chance
in Lefka to activate dead nodes whose energy level goes below a threshold value?
To deactivate the dead nodes, you mean? Deactivation of the dead nodes, you said?
Yeah, is there any chance?
Actually, the dead nodes are also deactivated, Professor, because they became out of energy and they did not attend any transmission, any measurements. And we go on the protocol with live nodes from the network. So dead nodes are automatically eliminated from the network.
Okay. So what is the minimum distance between your base station and cluster head, which is near to the base station? Is there any, I mean, the distance, minimum distance to you maintain?
Minimum distance?
Between
to the, actually, in our network, we assume there is no distance constraints for the nodes, but in real-time scenarios, the sensor nodes has distance constraints. So we should assume that they cannot reach this distance and their coverage is limited. But especially for the sensor nodes, this value is approximately 5 meters, 10 meters. It is changing. So you should provide a connection near to a sensor node in 5 meter distance. Provide full connection. So your answer is, for our simulations and evaluations, we assume that all nodes can reach to any node, and all nodes also can reach in real time. It's not possible. You cannot do like that because they are very small devices and they have very small antennas, you know. So they can just reach to 5 meters apart from their locations.
Okay, so what are the possible application of this particular wireless sensor network?
Especially, they are used very different places and applications, but For recent years, by using also, you know, the Internet of Things technologies, they are used in patient monitoring, and also especially the monitoring the patients from the remote, for example, their houses and their clinic applications, widely used in healthcare applications, the sensor nodes, and especially for recent years, it is used for underwater measurements, particularly for earthquake measurements, and sometimes in the forests, they use for fire measurements, and in addition, sometimes they can be used for indoor positioning systems, especially the shopping centers and finding the gates in airports.
Okay.
So maybe volcanic measurements, they can be used because you can scatter the sensor node from an helicopter, and then you can collect information remotely. For example, for 3 months, for 1 year, by using wireless sensor network. So they can be applied very various fields. There is no problem. You can apply it.
Okay. So one more question. As you told, LEFCA cannot be used in mobile environment. So sensor nodes are deployed. I mean, can it be deployed in a structured manner or static manner?
Yes, actually our nodes are static. They cannot move, and they are deployed in the environment, and their locations are fixed. So to apply LEFCA for mobile environments, we should make further analyzes and further evaluations. Also, this is an open problem for us, and from our listeners and our professors, PhD students, I'm open for collaborations. They can email me and contact me.
Okay.
If they have any solution for that, we can study together. It's very possible to generate new solutions and new publications together. So I'm still saying that I'm open for collaborations with you.
Oh, very nice. So please share your mail ID with all the participants so that they can contact you afterwards.
Good.
Hello.
I'm now typing now my email.
Okay.
I type. I'm waiting their comments and also their contributions and for future studies.
Sure. So I hope there is no more question from the audience, from the participants, and Dr. Kohan. It's a nice. It's our pleasure to have you for this session, and you just discussed a very. Current technology, very new technology of wireless sensor network field. So I hope many of the participants would like to apply this or would like to work in this area. So thank you. Thank you for being with us. And so this is at the end of the session. So thank you Dr. Kohan.
You are always welcome. Thank you for inviting, and also thank you for listening for all participants. Again, I'm open for collaborations with you. You can reach me, and for future presentations also I can join you again.
Okay, thank you so much.
Also, thank you to all, and you are all welcome.
Thank you. Okay. So, dear participants, so today we concluded our second session lecture. Tomorrow again we have two more sessions, and you will get all information from the WhatsApp group and Telegram group, and I hope all of you will join tomorrow at 10:45. We have the lecture at 11, but try to join before 10 or 15 minutes. So till then, goodbye. Thank you all. Okay.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.